Hello, I'm Debra Maria Carvalho with Authentic Hypnosis, Healing the Spirit and the Mind. I'm going to do a small series of the seven chakras, the colors involved in those energy centers, and how best that you can utilize them with lots of fun and getting yourself balanced and healthy. And today's color is the color red, the root chakra. Today we are going to speak about the first chakra, the root chakra. That is the color red. That's the characteristic of the root chakra. It's survival. It's anger. It's fear. It's compulsive exercising. It's alcohol and sex. Those are all negative things when they're not balanced properly. So I'm going to teach you a few little tricks to help you start balancing out your root chakra, red. This here is a beautiful stone, obsidian. It's great for protection. Wonderful to wear in smaller form, of course. My wonderful nephew, Noah, gifted this to me. Thank you, Noah. I love it, and it's always at my front door, and of course we don't have any problems around here. So I appreciate it, and I appreciate you. Love you, sweetie. Stones, crystals that help represent the color red, your root chakra, your base chakra. Pyrite. I happen to be wearing some beautiful pyrite. Also great for wealth manifestation, by the way. Rubies, great stone. And obsidian's great to handle fear and anger and really grounding and balance and protection. So let's talk about the root chakra briefly. It's the, when it's in balance, it's the fear and flight. So if you are in balance, you might be running away from something that you shouldn't be. It's a survival mode. So it's important that it's balanced and secure, and that you're rooted into the Mother Gaia. Very important. This way you have control of your life. Also, not to run away from yourself. Fear, right? False experiences appearing real. Taking again that your superconscious, subconscious controls 80% of your dialogue, your internal dialogue. That recording that's always going, telling you you're this, that, or the other thing, and it's usually negative. Very important to work with balancing the root chakra, the base chakra. It's right at the base of your spine, and the color is red. Great way to get grounded immediately is to take off your shoes and your socks and get out in nature and step on a lawn. Stay on a beautiful piece of green grass and just allow your body and your nerves to penetrate Mother Earth. Grab some of that love. That's a great way to get quick love, a great dose of love from Mother Gaia, and a really quick way to get yourself balanced and grounded immediately, that first chakra, keeping you from running away from things that maybe you don't need to be running away from, keeping your survival mode in check and your fear in balance, okay, which shouldn't exist in your universe, anybody's universe. It's all made up, it's all a collective dream. So dream a nice dream. And all you need is like 5-10 minutes on the lawn. On a piece of grass. Go to a park if you don't have a yard. Begin bringing that color red to help ground yourself, especially when you're outdoors or not, but preferably outdoors and on grass barefoot. You're gonna start bringing that red into your body from the top of your crown, into your head, into your body, filling you up, and bringing it down the spine of your back. So get it down, 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 and fill it up with lots of beautiful red. Not an orangey red, not a yellowy red, red. A nice, strong, beautiful, gorgeous red, like perhaps this fantastic rose. A beautiful red. Beautiful red, or like my sweater today. A beautiful red. And work that color. Bring it into Mother Nature. Get relaxed with it. Get yourself grounded. Breathe deeply. Breathe in the beautiful fresh air. You'll start noticing the beautiful sounds, hopefully birds around you, and how beautiful it feels. And if you get grounded enough, you can actually feel the earth moving, humming, rotating, spinning, and we're all a part of that. Another great way to get grounded is go for a walk in nature. Go out, take a little hike or walk around the park. Get out and get in nature and breathe deeply from the bottom of your belly in, bringing in again the color red. And bring it in, bring it in, bring it in. Breathe it in your entire body. But I want you to root yourself like a tree roots itself. Once the color red is coming down your spine, you filled yourself up, you feel grounded, you're part of nature, or standing on it, sitting on it, or even under a tree, but not during lightning and thunderstorms, think. So envision yourself that you are the tree. You are part of Mother Nature, because we are. You're growing now, like you're the canopy of the tree, but everything coming out of the base of your spine are now the roots. Getting grounded, getting secure, just like a beautiful big heritage oak. It has a huge root system, an enormous tap system. It's grounded in Mother Earth. It doesn't have any issues. It has a great time. Squirrels play on it, they eat off it, they nest off it, they make love on it. They do all sorts of beautiful things. It's grounded, it's strong, it's healthy. It is a wonderful way for you to recall and to remember trees, the roots, the grounding. So a great way that I like to ground myself is to do exactly what I've been telling you, bringing the color in, and then from my bottom of my spine down, I start having this gorgeous, wonderful cord, thick, huge cord coming down through the ground, penetrating the crust of Mother Gaia. And I used a crystal, so I'll put garnets. I'll attach beautiful garnets to them. Huge, glorious garnets. And hematite, and bloodstones, and rubies, and pyrite. All of the wonderful stones, I continue it down, 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 penetrating through crust and crust of earth, all the way down, all the way down, all the way down and through the other side of Mother Earth. So now it has penetrated through the axis of the planet Earth, and it is now basically attached to the bottom part of it. And that's when I like to put such a thing as obsidian. So it's gonna be a lot bigger than this, by the way. Those garnets that I think of and stuff, they're like this big or larger. And if that doesn't ground you, I really can't help you. I'm just kidding. It will ground you, trust me. Now you don't have to, I'm using it as an example. This is just like one of those things that I do when I really feel that I need lots of extra grounding and to shrug off, you know, fear, which is a false experience appearing real, and things of this nature or negative energy, I will ground myself. So if you're finding yourself drinking too much alcohol, your root chakra is not in balance. If you find yourself compulsively exercising, your root chakra needs to get back in check. Go out in nature and sit under a tree or in a park and practice that instead of running around it, okay? If you are feeling frightened all the time, your root chakra needs attention. It needs to have some balance. If you're always afraid, red, practice on that root chakra. Bring the red in, bring it down, work your body that way. Attach it to Mother Nature. Get out and breathe her in. We're surrounded by fabulous Mother Nature all the time. She's there to help ground us so we don't fly off the universe. I hope this has been helpful. There'll be many more chakras that I'll be discussing, and the colors and the traits, and they're all different, so please stay tuned. They're fun, they're free. Hit the red subscribe button and pass it on to your friends. Have a beautiful day. Namaste. Thank you. Hello, and thank you so much for joining me. There will be many YouTube videos available to you, workshops available, for free available to you. Please take full advantage of them. Hit that red subscribe button, and don't forget to hit that bell as well, because that way you won't miss a beat. Thanks again for joining me. Namaste.